Welcome to the podcast about venture capital, where investors and founders alike can learn how VCs make decisions and reach conviction. Your host is Nick Moran, and this is The Full Ratchet.
Welcome back to TFR for a special installment of Investor Stories. In this segment, the investors tell a story about some of the most odd and unusual situations they've ever encountered as investors. This is the segment called The Strange and Unusual. On today's special segment, we have Elizabeth Yin of Hustle Fund. Elizabeth, can you tell us a story about the craziest situation or pitch you've encountered?
I think at 500 startups, we got pitched like a mushroom death suit and actually ended up investing.
What?
Yeah, it was, I think some people pick out, coffins or whatever to be buried in when you pass, or I guess before you pass, you make that decision. Other people may decide to pick a decomposing suit made out of mushrooms.
Wow.
So there's some really out there things.
Wow. On today's special segment, we have Michael Cardamone of Accelaprise. Michael, can you tell us a story about the craziest situation or pitch that you've encountered?
Yeah, so I think one of the things, we had one situation where we found out one of the founders of a company and the CEO of the company kind of brought it to our attention, and they found out was basically acting fraudulently. Like there was, they were kind of taking money from the company that they shouldn't have been. And that was something that I never braced myself for that sort of behavior, I don't think, and never thought I would see it, but it makes sense given the volume of companies we're at. Like there's always going to be some bad apples that are like hard to suss out in certain situations. And so that was a big challenge that I think I learned from and had to deal with that hopefully I don't have to deal with again or very often in my career, but, yeah. But was like a very tough situation.
On today's special segment, we have Gigi Levy-Weiss of NFX. Gigi, can you tell us a story about the strangest or most unusual or most memorable startup pitch that you've ever received?
There has been, I've had airplane pitches, I've had elevator pitches, I've had, I've had motorcycle pitches. I've had somebody stop next to me. Israel is a small place and everybody knows everybody. I had somebody stop next to me when I'm walking in the street with a motorcycle, says, "Hey, you're Gigi." And I say, "Yes." And he said, "I've got an idea for you." So I've had that. I've had waiters that, that stopped me while serving food and said, "You got the food now. So while you're eating, let me pitch you." I've had a bunch. I've really had every possible funny thing. I've even had one company. I'm not going to say the name though, wouldn't embarrass the founder, but who basically, and I ended up investing. That's a funny one. But the founder actually, in the meeting, which was in a coffee shop, after me asking a bunch of hard questions, he looked at me and said, "You VCs literally don't understand anything. I've been having this process with so many of you and you just waste my time. I think we better just stop the meeting." And I'm like, what did you just do? I mean, and he said, "You clearly don't get it, right?" And I'm like, I don't know. I'm asking questions. And he said, "Well, maybe you're just not the right investor." And I was shocked. He was clearly not very much in love with the VC profession. And then I said, "You know what? Let's stop for a second. Let's take it a few steps back." And I ended up investing in the company.
Wow.
But giving him then a few lessons about how to fundraise, because that was, I don't think it would have worked with many other investors.
On today's special segment, we have Niki Pezeshki of Felicis. Niki, what's the strangest, most unusual, or most memorable startup pitch you've received?
Oh, man. My friends and I always joke, a lot of my friends in venture are like, that are not in venture, that we always joke about like funny startups ideas. You know, we always joke about a venture-backed water bottle company. And, you know, when I saw Liquid Death get funded, you know, I have no idea how Liquid Death is doing it. Honestly, might be an amazing venture investment. But it was pretty fun to see that pitch after, you know, my friends and I had talked about a venture-backed water company. You know, we've gotten, you know, as you can imagine, my friends and I also joke a good amount about like Facebook for pets. I've gotten a few Facebook for pets pitches. And you know, so they just keep coming. You know, there was a lot of like pretty crazy stuff I saw when crypto was hot that just made me just my head spin. You know, in general, I think you got to give, you know, got to give founders a lot of credit because, you know, they're much braver than I am. They're going out there quitting their jobs, you know, not taking on a salary and starting something that they really think should be out there in the world. And, you know, the person that started the Facebook for pets company, the person that started like the water company, you know, they see an opportunity that maybe I don't see. And, you know, it's just up to them to go prove that that is going to be an amazing business, an amazing company, and make me bite my tongue.
Yeah. I saw Liquid Death at Whole Foods.
Yeah. I'm sure they're doing great. It's a great idea, but like, and I maybe underestimated it and I kind of shouldn't have. You know, I'm super happy for the investors there and the founder and the whole team. And I hope they're doing really great. You just asked for strange pitches. And I think when you join venture capital, you probably don't think that you're going to be pitched on a startup for bottled water.
Right. Is it just water in cans? I mean, is that the angle?
Cans are a little bit more sustainable than plastic bottles are. And so I think there's a little bit of a kind of environmental bend to the pitch and to the reason why consumers would be excited, which I have a lot of respect for. Yeah.
That will conclude this installment of Investor Stories. If you're enjoying the program and would like to see it continue, take a moment and leave a 5-star review in iTunes. Also, if you'd like updates on new content from TFR, as well as the top 10 VC articles every week, go to fullratchet.net and sign up for the newsletter. Okay, that will wrap things up for today. Until next time, overprepare, choose carefully, and invest confidently. Thanks for joining me.